1975, of course, the formation of the Catholic Junior College. The aim then, as it still is today, is to provide a holistic education, as you've heard, to students preparing for the GCSE A-level examinations, which will be marked by, firstly, how well the college value adds to them, that they will be on an educational trajectory that is different from when they first entered. And secondly, the longer it's an effect of how they want to create positive social impact wherever life may take them. The journey of refreshing the CJC Press also began with a look ahead. Ahead to 2015, a mere 2 years from now when we celebrate our 40th anniversary. We thought about what we've achieved, but also what we hope the college will be. We have a firm foundation, thanks to former school leaders. I just want to recognize the presence of former principal, Dr. Rogers, as well as former students. We know our strengths, which is in humanities and languages, and we can take pride of the fact that our old boys and old girls, many of whom are seated here, including members of the first batch, who are represented at the highest levels in industry, in government, in academia, and media. Being a member of the school management committee, I can see that the SMC, or the board for short, is also acutely aware of the areas in which we can do better. With the 40th year milestone in sight, our foundation, our track record in mind, the board embarked on a strategic review for the college in 2010. And true to our mission, our current principal, Mrs. Christine Kong, has been leading the way systematically looking at how we can do better. In two ways, certainly. First, to improve the pedagogy and the academic content of what we do here. And second, in creating the conditions and channels for which character development, training in life and work skills, and the nurturing of a social conscience can take place here. So we care about students' grades, but more importantly, we care about students' lives. How they live in school, beyond its walls, and out there in the community. I think students here, the year threes, the year twos, have had a flavor of what this fresh impetus has meant through the Ignite program, which has been referred to this afternoon. And this is where teachers stretch students in critical thinking, conceptual understanding, interdisciplinary studies. And through rigorous service learning projects, I think students deliberate on the social and political issues we face as Singaporeans in this country and we face as global citizens. The Ignite program is a prototype program which will be refined to take us to the gold standard of academic excellence implemented college-wide so that students college-wide can be leveled up to that standard over time. So now that I've talked about the strategic review, let me get to the quest. As the school management was undertaking a strategic review, the board decided that our crest and our branding must reflect not just our foundation and history, but that aspiration to take the school from today and beyond to a higher level than we are at the moment. So our aspirations. The current crest, adopted in 1975, reminds us that the college attains to its dual mission, remember, academic excellence and also service orientation. If we remember our Catholic underpinnings and inspiration. But the question we pose to ourselves is, what more can we do to ensure that our crest reflects our aspirations for the college as we head to our 40th mark? So in the third quarter in 2011, that is what we did. The board tasked a team to look at how we can refresh the crest so that it can be a very effective graphic representation of our foundation, our history, and and most importantly, our aspirations. And Boyd also said another thing, to ensure that as we did that, we would engage the CJC community closely. And I'm very happy to have been involved in that work. So as the journey unfolded, it became clear that on the practical front, we needed to do three things. First, to improve on the artwork, and the technology since 1975 certainly allows us to do that. Secondly, to give, and students know this, our much loved college fame, pride of place in the press. And third, it was to ensure that the outcome would convey that sense of dynamism that we want in our college going forward. So let's take a look at the current press, right?
Spirit descending on the CJC community to give us strength and inspiration to fulfill our mission. And it is a spirit of truth and love, and hence the motto college, in truth and in love, in veritate. You see the tongues of fire that reinforce the notion of the descent of the Spirit of God that was written in the book of Acts. There is a four-pointed star in this crest, which symbolizes the cross of Christ. But of course, you will immediately tell me it's not one star, it's two. So it's really an artistic device to anchor the crest. So this is the current crest, and it's in the shape of a shield. There were three principal stages in our design process. First, the conceptual stage, and designers were commissioned to create three conceptual ideas, and many of you then went online to survey to give your views. Right? These were students, former students, staff, former staff, teachers, parents, anybody was allowed to pay. And we got 2,393 inputs. And we took the votes and the comments, and we took very seriously the negative comments as well. Okay? So that we could refine this and really encapsulate what the college really wants. As we did the survey, we also did the survey on the tagline, and that's what we've arrived at. We saw this afternoon. Our aim for every CJC student to be a thinker with a mission, a leader with a heart. Stage two, the refinement stage. As we were refining the ideas after we got them from the survey, we then were looking at the nitty-gritties of the design and we organized focus groups, seven in all, to get more views. We are very grateful that members of the alumni, members of alumni with creative industries, students, parents of students, staff, members of the public community came and gave their input. There was a broad consensus of what the design should do, but yet it is. They said that the design must speak of a few things. Community, care, excellence, impact, vibrancy, and that the press should look like the old one, as far as possible. Third, the design stage. So the SFC convened a design-making council comprising nine people. It included the chairman of the board, Mr. Durami, principal, chaplain, a representative of the student council, your president, Mr. Phoenix Unway. Teachers, Mr. Eugene Liao, head of the parent support group, Mr. Winston Tang, alumnus, Professor Tan Jun Han, Ms. Teo Su Len, and a representative from the CJC Alumni Association, which I hope the three students will join later. That rep was Mr. Simon Tan. The council then decided. They sent us back to refine the ideas some more. And we traversed the final mile slowly but surely, and a vote was taken. And that brings us to today. You will see shortly, okay? I'm so nervous. You will see shortly that the TAF is in all of the college, of course. But I hope you will agree that it looks elegant, and yet it is in an active stage of descending upon us to help keep Christ alive in the community, where Christ is represented as a cross, a cross, just one. This replaces the two stars of the current dress. The college frame takes pride of place in its full glory above the words CJC, so that it represents the torch of the life God of knowledge and wisdom to guide us along the way. The shield is returned to speak of the need to guard ourselves from evil and to live in truth and love. The gold is retained to speak of the excellence we seek in how we learn and we live. We very much hope it captures the aspiration to be a dynamic, vibrant college community that brings light and positive social influence to wherever its members are found. You'll be relieved to know that in practice, the flame will continue to be the short signature of the college. Yes? Happy? The crest will be found in more formal and institutional collaterals. There will be no change to the uniform, no change to the collar badge, and no change to the navy blazers. It will take the team about a few months more to weave all of this into all our collaterals, and so I hope you'll be patient with us. As I close, I would like to say that I've been struck by the passion of all those who have shared their views. Everyone out there who cares about the college. All of them care dearly for the past, but they also care very much about the future of the college. And I wish to thank them all for their input, and especially members of the Design Making Council, the design team that is also headed by the alumnus director. Because she, not being an alumnus, was just as earnest in doing her very best for us. So, each of you, in that light blue uniform with that flame on your collar, you are ambassador of the college. And today, with the unveiling of the crest, you know that the many I talked about, the students, the former students, the principal, the former principals, and staff, many of them who came before you wish you the best and hope that you too, as we unveil this crest, will renew your commitment to give your best, first to yourself and second to the college. And remember that if ever the going gets tough, this crest reminds you to look heavenward for everything that you need. This broader CGC community hopes that you will go out there and strengthen the brand and be the salt and light of the world. Let people see that the world is a better place because of your presence, because you are CGC. In veritate, in caritate. Thank you.
Thank you. there is fresh press and significance written in explanation.
This launch will not complete without the College's special appreciation to Dr. Gilito for her invaluable contributions to the panel. We now invite Mr. Charlie, Chairman of the College Board of Presidential Association, Dr. Gilito. Dr. Gilito and Mr. Charlie, please. Thank you, Mr. Lee. We are now invited to the prayer.